हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वेलकम बैक आवर ऑनलाइन क्लास साइंस 7th स्टैंडर्ड। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू आवर 15th चैप्टर। सो इन प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑलरेडी यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट दैट व्हाट इज द टोर्नाडोस एंड व्हाट आर द लाइक थंडरस्टॉर्म्स। बट स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन दिस वीडियो दैट इज साइक्लोन्स। साइक्लोन्स इज वन ऑफ द थिंग्स दैट लाइक स्टॉर्म्स, but it is a difference due to that low pressure in that our ocean or the Bay of Bengal or that like a sea. Okay, so especially when that due to that heavy sunlight, the surface, the surroundings, that it will get that more hot airs, and that airs will get heat and it will start to go rises to off, and whenever that it will be go to off, then at that time that cool airs nearby the surroundings, it will try to come to that complete to the overcome the that gap. And if other time what will happen, that all cool air try to rushes to enter or to go to that empty place. So other time that water cycles or water surface of that it will be move to that particular place. So other time what will happen, there are so many waves it will create, and that center points it will be like a circle, like it will be rotates. And due to that low pressure, generally cyclones are occurring in our India. There are so many coastal areas, and that coastal areas, that those peoples, they are affected by the cyclones every year, May months, and especially this November, that is October, and October to November months, that Bay of Bengal, there more time number of times that cyclones are affecting due to the specially that what happening due to the low pressure in the Bay of Bengal or Arabian Sea, and especially Indian Sea, and if it will be occur in that Pacific Ocean, western side of that Pacific Ocean, that is called as also different name, that is a typhoon. And especially if that cyclones will occur in that our Bay of Bengal or in Indian Ocean, that is called as a simple cyclones. So that radius of that cyclones, it is near about that 150 kilometers, and that speed of that cyclones, sometimes it is very heavy cyclones, means near about 100 kilometer above, and near starting that 65 to 70 kilometers the normal cyclones are like that. So, and also cyclones that every countries in the world over, so this is one of world over phenomena, means everywhere water is there, and every countries all over the world that they are facing this cyclones, because that is nearby that water is there. So what will happen there? So in world there come minerals that things their scientists, they have given that one way, and they are giving that every countries term wise they are giving their names. So like Hudu Hudu, okay, that is Pralaya, and there is so many that countries, they last time that Bangladesh had given that names, that before that India they are given next Pakistan, same like term wise that whatever the cyclones will occur in around that our earth, in the any place of that that world, that which term of which country will come, they will give that name of that cyclones. So these cyclones especially it is occurring due to that low pressure on the surface of the water. Okay, so students, how that precaution we have to take, before that we have to listen all that information. Precaution, whenever that actually they will find out that what our department, that our weather forecasting departments and meteorological departments, they will get that forecasting, that about that information they will give by TV news and newspaper and radio, they will announcement by that by people with it, and different way they will give that information. But we should not be ignore about that, we don't want to careless about that information. We must take care, and before that we have to vacate our rooms, and we have to go to one particular place where it is, it won't be affected. Okay, and sea coastal area people, that should be take care about that, and compulsory we have to take the numbers, phone numbers, police, like that doctor, that hospital's number, ambulance, that like numbers, and fires numbers. And whenever that cyclones are also, it will occur at that time, we should not use that electricity, because we have to main switch, we have to off, because when the cyclones will come, sometimes it will damage our houses, it will damage that electric cords, and we should not go outside also. So different things are there, precautions we have to study. So let us discuss first of all that what is that cyclones. Okay, a storm which develops on the sea and has a high speed winds swirling around a low pressure center. One low pressure center, when the low pressure will come, that around that what will happen, one swirl like chakra, like wheels, like it will swelling around the breast, low pressure center, and it develops over a topical cyst. Then after what will happen? Well, slowly it will come to that soap sea beach and it will come to that lands. Okay, and due to the low pressure, cold air from the surroundings rushes in and rises out, and the result that will hit the sun. This process continues the setting of the current of air. The center of the cyclones, which also called as a high, is calm area with a diameter about 10 km to 30 km. Where is the center? Where is the low pressure we are created? Where that swirling like swirling the wheels like that waters at that particular the region? How much? Near about 10 km to 30 km that diameter there. The cyclones developing in that western Pacific region are called typhoons. If the cyclones will develop in that Pacific regions, that Pacific western side of that Pacific that regions, that is called as a typhoons. But if in cyclones developing over India Ocean or Bay of Bengal, simply we can say that is the cyclones. Cyclones produce the jet waves in the sea along with the torrential rains. Whenever the cyclones, it will happen at that time, what will happen? Heavy breeze, it will be move one day, and also with that also heavy rains will be fall. That's why we have to be faced at a lot of problems, and it will be also damage that more houses, clothes, that of our agricultures, road, electricity, all that things, whatever that physically we have made, naturally or artificial we have made that our for our needs, that all that things about that, if that it will come under that radius, then it's compulsory, it will damage all that. Okay, it is very heavy pressures and heavy speed of that winds, and also heavy rains are there, and big roots, the trees also will be get that uprooted, and all roads will bridge, damage, it will get that damages, houses, if there is no pakka house like that also, if that also it will be damaged. So it is very dangerous storms, like it is one natural calamities, and you have to take that precautions. So what are the precautions we have to see? Warning issued by the meteorological department through the TV, radio, newspaper should not be ignored. Whatever the meteorological department is giving the information or the weather forecasting, the department or they are giving that what information about that cyclones, you must take it seriously, don't be neglected. And people living cyclones prone areas should make arrangements of the shift necessary household goods, domestic animals and vehicles to for the safer place. Before getting that information, you have to take that our all the items needs for daily, and all the things which one is more like a property, like all the things we have to take, and we have to vacate that rooms place, and we have to go safer places before the cyclones are affecting. Phone numbers of all emergency service like hospitals, fire and police should be kept in your hand, and if emergency will happen anything, that before you have to keep that your phone numbers. And those of that like ambulance number, hospitals numbers, and fire stations numbers, that you have to keep with you. If you accidentally if it affect or happened anything, that means you have to contact to them. Okay, so these are all about the students precautions and about that cyclones, about that what is that cyclones, and weather instruments, how that it is using, how can we detect whatever that we will discuss also. Okay, so now see students, weather instruments, that some instruments are using for that to find out the speed of the wind, that is called as a anemometer. Okay, what is that? You should say anemometer. The speed of wind is measured by an instrument that is called as a anemometer, and another instrument through which the direction of blowing wind can be detected is called as a weather vane and weather vane. Okay, wind vane. Okay, so which direction that wind will flow, from which direction it will come, that we can find out easily. So that is called as a wind vane or weather vane. Okay, and which instrument speed detecting how much speed that wind will flow, that we can say that is called as a what is that anemometer. Okay, and the pressure of that air we are getting, that is a barometer, already you know that air pressures. So this speed of the wind is called as anemometer, that instruments are using, and a direction we are finding for that instrument we are using weather vane. Okay students, I hope you have understood about this chapter thoroughly, and you have to that all the things, these are the determination that are like a theoretical part, that you have to read that all that things whatever that are in textbook. Okay, so students, my sincere request, you should from the chapter first for total all activities, all the things, textbooks you have to read and underline, and also get that all that information, remain information. Okay, students, and it has completed your chapter. Next, we have to see that our exercise part, objectives, and all the things. Thank you all of you. Have a nice day.